Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me this morning is Steve Roebuck, CEO at Avidian Gold. Steve, it's good to meet you. How are you?
I'm very good and nice to meet you too, Christine.
Steve, if you would, just give us a quick introduction about the company. Tell me more about Avidian Gold and its properties.
Sure. We were formed in 2017 by a gentleman by the name of David Anderson. So he's a serial winner. He sold two gold companies in the past for $1 billion. We're trading on the Toronto Stock Exchange and the OTCQB. We've got a very experienced board of directors. We are focused in Alaska and in Nevada. We've got three projects in Alaska. They're all within the Tintina Gold Belt. Two of the projects are sitting right beside the Fort Knox mine, owned by Kinross, just a little bit north of Fairbanks. Our other project is called the Golden Zone. It's a very large footprint project, and it's extremely well located, being about 10 kilometers west of the highway, the rail, and the power. And that's an incredible advantage for anybody in our business, being so close to infrastructure. At the Golden Zone, we've got the Breccia Pipe deposit, which is a 300,000 ounce deposit and about 1.5 million ounces of silver as well. In 2021, we were very active on our drilling campaign. And so we've just been releasing some extremely interesting results over the last, I guess, February 2nd, January 19th were the dates for the last press releases, in which we outlined a new 600 meter trend called the Mayflower Extension Zone away from the Breccia Pipe deposit itself.
Lots on the go for you.
Yes.
See, from my understanding, Avidian is spinning out a subsidiary called HighTide Resources. Could you tell me a bit about the reasoning behind this?
Sure. It was with Avidian having both precious metals in Alaska and Nevada and base metals in Eastern Canada, it was a little bit clumsy at times to tell that story. What we've done is that by breaking them apart, we've got a gold-focused, U.S.-focused company and a base metal Canada-focused company. So it made a lot of sense to separate the assets and create a new company. Avidian is a major shareholder in HighTide. It's been raising money for that company for the past 2 years. And just on Monday of this week, we announced that the spin out of HighTide. And that's been 6 months worth of work in the background, getting all of the I's dotted, T's crossed prospectus, the Ontario Securities Commission, the Canadian Securities Exchange, all that work that's been done. But whew, we're really at the goal line right now. So it's exciting times that we're doing that. And we hope to have HighTide trading on the CSE before the end of the month. So February, it's only a couple of weeks away. Now, the interesting thing is that since Avidian has been funding HighTide for these years, we've been accumulating a large share position within that company. And we are going to be offering 9.4 million shares as a dividend for the existing shareholders of Avidian is a free dividend. So, I mean, that's who doesn't like free? Everyone loves free. So, for example, if you've got 17,000 shares in Avidian, you're going to get 1,000 free shares of HighTide. So it's kind of quite the bonus putting it all together.
You have a date in mind for that?
Yeah, thanks for asking. February 15th is an important date. The date of record is actually February 17th. So this is next week. But you have to have a settlement a couple of days ahead of time. So anybody who really wants to participate in the free share distribution, you want to have your shares by February the 15th.
With that being said, could you just tell me a bit more of some of HighTide's projects?
Sure. We've got two projects in the Southern Labrador Trough. And really, the Southern Labrador Trough is a major geological structure that runs through Quebec and through Labrador. There's many, many, many. It's basically Canada's iron ore belt, kind of our Pilbara, so to speak. We have one project, and again, similar to Alaska, it's important to be close to infrastructure, and both of our projects are located adjacent to critical infrastructure. So the Labrador West is an iron ore project. It's an advanced stage, and it's literally right beside Canada's largest iron ore mine, which is Carroll Lake, which is about 23 million tons per year of product. It's owned by Rio Tinto. They're a majority owner, along with, I think, Mitsubishi and Labrador Iron Ore Royalty Trust Corporation, etc. So that's, you know, again, you've got all the infrastructure that you need. You got a workforce, you got rail, you got rail to port, you got highways, you've got airport, you got a skilled workforce. You've got literally everything that you need right in that vicinity. So our plan is to this spring, summer, is to engage in a drilling campaign. Now, I said this was an advanced stage project, and it is so because Rio Tinto drilled 18 holes, about 4,200 meters back in 2010, 11, and 12. We picked the project up in 2019. In 2020, we drilled four more holes, another 1,000. So there's already 22 holes, 5,200 meters. There's been all sorts of geophysics, airborne LIDAR, et cetera. So we have an extremely high level of confidence and understanding of the asset as it stands right now. So what we need to do is drill about 5 to 7 holes, well positioned in between, shutting that gap down where we've got 300 meters between this hole and 300. You can't stitch that together into a resource. But if you kind of fill those gaps in, you're looking at a pretty bite-sized program, 5 to 7 holes, about 2,500 meters. As I said, we hope to get that going this spring, this summer. Really depends on drill availability. It's a busy year, as you very well know. But we look to get a maiden resource this year, and then follow up with a PEA. This is not something that's going to be going into 2023, 24, waiting for something to happen. I think we can compress the time schedule, and our target is a minimum of about 500 million tons of iron. So very important. And again, you know, daylighting a new deposit in the heart of iron country, nothing like this has been done in 20 years. That kind of makes us a little bit unique, a little bit of a unicorn at this point in time. And iron ore is smoking hot. Last year, it got overheated. It went to 220 a ton for Fe62. It backed off, but boy, it's roared back up again, and we're back to $150 a ton. And so the timing could not be better at all. You're coming out, you're trading, you've got a great project, great jurisdiction, you're ready to go. And that's important too, is that we're fully funded. We've got over $3 million in the kitty for HighTide. You know, we're in a really good position. So that's good. And then Lac Pegma, I did mention Lac Pegma. We do have a project just over the border in Quebec, and that's a copper nickel cobalt project. And there's one hole that's very, there's 80 drill holes put into this over the years. And it only had 1 year's worth of exploration done in 1996. And funny enough, I was the very young project geologist who just drilled the discovery hole, so to speak, in that campaign. And I sat back for 25 years waiting to see if this project would become available. I picked it up. So one of the drill holes, I think, is 18 meters of about 1.15% nickel, 0.7% copper. Very compelling grades. It's historic in nature, so it needs a refresh. And so we're going to have to do a lot of work on that project this summer. So, but it's early days yet on that one, but certainly our flagship project again is very much the Labrador West.
Exciting times ahead. Steve, before I let you go, could you shed some light on who some of your top shareholders are?
Top shareholder, for sure, is Eric Sprott. He's got over 12% of the company. That's a major validation for Avidian Gold. You know that Eric does his homework. He invests in companies with good assets and good management teams. And I think that, you know, we clearly checked all those boxes. After that would be David Anderson, our former chairman. And David actually just, when I say foreman, he stepped down on Monday and to pursue the finer things in life when you've been successful. So but David's around as a special advisor to the corporation, and he is a very large shareholder. Crescat Capital's in there. and a number of high net worth individuals that are around the company. So we're in good shape on the shareholder list for sure.
All right. I'm excited to follow your progress here. Steve, really good to meet you. Thanks so much.
Well, thank you very much for your time.